Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain.
Hello, a very good day to you. My name is Sister Temitayo, and I'm here once again to share the Open Heavens Daily Devotional with you. And this is the Open Heavens Daily Devotional that I'm sharing. This one that is compiled by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. And if you're visiting my channel for the very first time, my name is Sister Temitayo, and the Lord instructed me to begin to share this Open Heavens Daily Devotional in 2020. This is my fourth year of sharing, and that's why we call it Season 4. And all those videos from 2020 are loaded on my YouTube channel. My handle on YouTube is Temi Agedo, which is right on the screen. I would encourage you to visit my channel, view the videos. They will definitely bless you. And while you're on there, please do subscribe. Pastor Adeboye led me to Christ in October 1997, a few years back when I was an undergraduate in the University of Lagos, Nigeria. And his unique style of teaching is that he'll give you a few scriptures from the Bible, a memory verse, and when you combine those two pieces of scripture, it helps you to understand the body of the text and what God is saying to the reader of the daily devotional. Praise God. So today is Friday, May the 12th, and we love Friday, thank God. The title of today's daily devotional is Divine Help Part 3. Divine Help Part 3. So we've been doing a three-day series on Divine Help, and I would encourage you to visit the channel, view the videos from Divine Help Part 1 and 2, which were on Wednesday and Thursday, so that you to give you a holistic picture and you're able to understand this particular reading much better. Praise God. So our scriptural reading is taken from the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 20 from verses 1 to 25. 2 Chronicles 20 verses 1 to 25. Quite a long read, but we rejoice at your word as one that findeth great spoil. Amen. So thus goes the reading of God's word. I'm going to be reading from the traditional King James Version. 2 Chronicles chapter 20 verses 1 to 25. Very popular chapter. If you've been coming to church regularly, it says, and it came to pass after this also that the children of Moab and the children of Ammon, with them other beside the Ammonites, came against Jehoshaphat to battle. Then there came some that told Jehoshaphat, saying, there cometh a great multitude against thee from beyond the sea on this side Syria. And behold, they be in Hazazon Tamar, which is En-Gedi. And Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord and proclaimed a fast throughout all Judah. And Judah gathered themselves together to ask ask help of the Lord. Even out of all the cities of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. And Jehoshaphat stood in the congregation of Judah and Jerusalem in the house of the Lord before the new court and said, O Lord God of our fathers, art not thou God in heaven, and rulest not thou over all the kingdoms of the heathen? And in thine hand is there not power and might, so that there is none, that none is able to withstand thee? Art not thou our God, who didst drive out the inhabitants of this land before thy people Israel, and gavest it to the seed, to thy seed, the seed of Abraham, thy friend forever? And they dwelt therein, and have built thee a sanctuary therein for thy name, saying, if when evil cometh upon us, as the sword, judgment, or pestilence, or famine, we stand before this house and in thy presence, for thy name is in this house, and cry unto thee in our affliction, then thou wilt hear and help. And now, behold, the children of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir, or whom thou wouldest not let Israel invade when they came out of the land of Egypt, but they turned from them and destroyed them not. Behold, I say how they reward us to come to us to cast us out of our possession, of thy possession, which thou hast given us to inherit. O our God, will thou not judge them? For we have no might against this great company that cometh against us, neither know we what to do, but our eyes are upon thee. And all Judah stood before the Lord with their little ones, their wives, and their children. Then upon Jehaziel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jael, the son of Methaniah, a Levite of the sons of Asaph, came the Spirit of the Lord in the midst of the congregation. And he said, hearken ye, all Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thy king Jehoshaphat. Thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid or dismayed by reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's. Tomorrow go ye down against them, Behold, they come up by the cliff of Ziph, and you shall find them at the end of the brook, before the wilderness of Jeruel. You shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourselves, stand still, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you, O Judah and Jerusalem. Fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow, go out against them, for the Lord will be with you. Praise God. Now, verse 18. And Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshipping the Lord, and the Levites and the children of the Kohathites and the children of Korahites stood up to praise the Lord God of Israel with a loud voice on high. And they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, "Hear me, O Judah and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. Believe his prophets, so shall ye prosper." And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and that they should praise the beauty of holiness as they went out before the army, and to say, "Praise the Lord, for his mercies endureth forever." And when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord sent ambushment against the children of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, which were come against Judah, and they were smitten. For the children of Ammon and Moab stood up against the inhabitants of Mount Seir, utterly to slay and destroy them. And when they had made an end of the inhabitants of Seir, everyone helped to destroy another. And when Judah came towards the watchtower in the wilderness, they looked unto the multitude, and behold, there were dead bodies falling to the ground, and none escaped. And when Jehoshaphat and his people came to take away the spoil of them, they found among them in abundance both riches with dead bodies and precious jewels, which they stripped off for themselves more than they could carry away. And they were 3 days in gathering of the spoil. It was so much. Praise God. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. 25 verses. Don't scroll past that, please. We rejoice at God's word as one that findeth great spoil. So listen to the word of God. The Bible says, "Sanctify and cleanse them with the washing of water by your word." Amen. So this is a very popular story. Most likely we've read it in the book of Kings. And what has happened here is that, you know, the kingdom had been divided. The 12 tribes had been divided. 10 tribes were called Israel and had their capital in Samaria, the northern kingdom. And then 2 tribes, Judah being the bigger one, and little Benjamin became what we call Judah. You know, and that's where the temple was. And they had their capital in Jerusalem. And the king at this time was King Jehoshaphat. And, you know, 3 nations, the Bible tells us 3 nations came against Judah. You know, the children of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir. And the children of Ammon and Moab were the children of Lot, and then Mount Seir were the children of Esau. And they came against the southern kingdom, against little Judah. And when they told Jehoshaphat, the king, he was afraid. And that can happen to anybody. But he did the right thing. When he was afraid, you know, he went straight to God. "Woe unto him that has not the Lord as his God." So he went to God and prayed. And the Spirit of God came upon somebody, Jehaziel, the son, great-grandson of Asaph, and God gave them a strategy. Now, there was just something I noticed about this strategy in verse 17. It says, "Stand ye still and see the salvation of the Lord." You know, you can't use the strategy from one place, from one scripture, and just use it. You have to know exactly what the Lord is saying. Because the last time that somebody says, "Stand ye still and see the salvation of the Lord," God said, "No, no, no, tell the people to go forward." Moses was telling the people to stand still, but God said, "No, go forward." You know, but here, this was a strategy that they stand still and they see the salvation of God. And God came through for them because they were helpless. You know, they could not physically fight this three-man nation. These three nations, they were powerless, but they were strengthened with might. God fought for them. Amen. And, you know, they didn't even lift a finger. They just kept singing that God is good and his mercies endure forever. And that song opens all doors, that God is good and his mercies endure forever. He sent help from heaven. Now, the memory verse is taken from the book of Matthew chapter 19, verses 26. "But Jesus beheld them and said unto them, with men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible." So it doesn't matter how the gang up is. If God be for you, none can be against. If God be for us, none can be against us. You know, the Bible says, one with God is a majority. If God is on our side, who can be against us? Hallelujah. So it doesn't matter their gang up. You know, one with God is a majority. Hallelujah. Pastor says that God can help you even when the odds against you are overwhelming. When he decides, he will show the odds that he's still the Almighty, all-sufficient God. In Isaiah 43, verse 13, the Almighty God says, no one can hinder when he decides to work. In other words, it doesn't matter how many forces are at war against you, when God decides to help you, nothing will stop you. And we see that even in modern day Israel, you know, as little as Israel is, the nations around her, aggressive, you know, hostile nations, no matter how much they try to attack her, she always comes out on top because the Lord is in the midst of her. You know, she shall not be moved. The Lord will help her, and that right early, the Bible says in Psalm 46, verse 5. And in this Isaiah 43, verse 13, that Pastor has quoted, I'm going to read from the New Living Translation. It says, Isaiah 43, verse 13 says, from eternity to eternity, I am God. No one can snatch anyone out of my hand, and no one can undo what I have done. You know, so don't join the multitude to do evil. Don't fight someone that God is supporting. Okay? God will always send help. It doesn't matter the gang up. God can save by the hands of many or by few. In Daniel 3, when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were thrown into the fiery furnace, the furnace was heated 7 times more. Yet the only people who died were the soldiers who threw the boys inside. The people thrown right into the furnace came out alive. The people thrown right into the furnace came out alive. In Judges 15, verse 11 to 15, Judges 15, verses 11 to 15, the Bible says that Samson's relatives handed him over to external enemies. But by the end of the day, 1,000 of these enemies were dead while the rest fled. It doesn't matter how many enemies you are dealing with, God will help you to deal with them all in Jesus' name. Yesterday, I quoted from Acts chapter 10, verses 38, that says how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. That word anointed, it means assisted, helped Jesus Christ of Nazareth by anointing him with the Holy Ghost and with power. You know, so, and this is what happened to Samson. His own family members were the ones that handed him over to the enemy. But then the Bible says that the Spirit of the Lord came upon him, and with the jawbone of an ass, he destroyed over 1,000 Philistines. So if God be for you, none can be against you. Just make sure that Jesus Christ is in your boat. Amen. Just make sure that you are born again. If you are born again, the Bible says, just God said, touch not my anointed and do my prophets no harm. Hallelujah. God is on our side. The psalmist said, the Lord is for me amongst them that help me. God is my helper, my ever-present help in time of trouble. In Psalms 46, verse 1, it says, the Lord is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in time of trouble. He's never late. He's not a late God. My God is the one who makes a way where there is no way. So when it looks like there is no way out, God can still make a way. One day, while I was abroad, I was told that one of my spiritual sons was in the hospital suffering from an advanced case of cancer. Humanly speaking, his case was completely hopeless. I went to visit him at the hospital on Saturday and prayed for him. By the following Wednesday, my son was discharged completely whole. The beauty of that story is that every other person who had been in the ward when I prayed for him was also discharged. God is a miracle working God. That song we sing, He's a miracle working God. He's a miracle working God. He is Alpha and Omega. He's the miracle working God. And the Bible says that He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's still in the business of working miracles. And Pastor gives a testimony. These are real testimonies of one of his sons who was in hospital with advanced. This was a long time ago. Not now that technology has, you know, improved. He had at some stage some advanced cancer, and you know, there was no hope for him really. But Pastor prayed for him in the hospital, you see, because God confirmed. You see, Joshua said something in this verse that we read. He said, believe the Lord your God, in verse 2 Chronicles 20:20. So believe the Lord your God and you shall be established. Believe his prophets and you shall prosper. So don't let anybody, when you're a Christian, you have a pastor. Make sure that your pastor knows you. Amen. Make sure that your pastor knows you must be a Christian. You must be attending church regularly. So when the enemy comes in, your shepherd can stand in the gap for you. Praise God. Believe the Lord your God, and you shall be, so shall you be established. believe his prophets, so shall ye prosper. Do you have a pastor? Amen. And that's exactly what happened. The prophet gave a word, and it was that word that brought them the victory. Amen. So that's what happened. This man could have died, but because he had a pastor, a shepherd, you know, he let his shepherd know what was going on in his life, and he prayed for him in the name of Jesus Christ. And God that answers prayers, honored the word. The Bible says that God confirms the word of his servant and performeth all the counsel of his messengers. You know, and he prayed for him, and the advanced cancer the next Wednesday he checked out. And you see, when God, he does great things. When God visited Paul and Silas in the jail, he broke not only their bands, he broke the bands of all the prisoners that were there. And that's exactly what happened here. Pastor says that not only was his son healed, all the people in the ward were all made whole. Because when God comes to visit, he does great things. He perfects everything. Hallelujah. I remember one of our sisters was giving a testimony of how she took a magazine called Healing to the Nations to a family member in the hospital. And then she gave it to the person who was sitting, who was in the next bed, and the man had not been eating. But by the time the man took the magazine and began to read of all the testimonies, he started eating like a horse. Praise God. You see, God is, he bringeth, he's a miracle working God. He's a good and kind God. Pastor said there was also a case of a lady that had been told by doctors that she had 99.99 chance of dying from a particular disease. I couldn't go to the hospital at that time, so I prayed on a handkerchief instead and sent it to her. God used the remaining 0.01% that the doctors left out to save her life. And she wrote a book titled Rescued from the Jaws of Death, testifying of her divine healing. I don't know how hopeless your case seems to be. Everyone may have given up on you, but I decree that God will make a way for you today in Jesus' name. You know, God, as many as come unto Christ, he will in no wise turn away. You know, God is faithful. And help came to the man who had been at the pool of Bethesda for 38 years. He said, I have no man. It's true that we have no man. We only have God, you know. So he left God out of the equation. But we know our God. We're strong in the Lord. We know our God. They that know their God, they shall be strong. You know, and this woman that pastor is talking about, I read about her. She had a heart disease. Her name is Bolaji Lola Adebi. You know, and she was very ill, and there was just no hope for her. And they informed the man of God that she was sick. So he prayed into a handkerchief like Paul, the very scriptural, and sent the handkerchief to her. And she came out whole and even wrote a book titled Rescued from the Jaws of Death. I read a bit of it, you know, and how God delivered her. It was a very hopeless situation. But with God, nothing shall be called impossible. All things. Jesus said in our memory verse, Matthew 19:26, that with men, this is impossible. But with God, all things are possible. Hallelujah. The prayer point is, Father, nothing is impossible with you. Please come to my rescue today in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you because you are our ever-present help in time of need, in time of trouble. Thank you because whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. No one has ever come to you and you have turned them back. We thank you because you are a miracle-working God, and the plans you have for us are plans of good and not of evil. We pray in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ that you come to our rescue in the mighty name of Jesus in that area where we need help. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, before we call you, you have heard. And while yet speaking, you've already performed. Thank you for your help, Almighty God. Thank you for the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you so much for taking time to listen to me. My name again is Sister Temi Tayo. And while you're on my channel, please do me a favor. Please subscribe. And God bless you as you do. My handle on YouTube is right on the channel. And I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. God bless you. My name again is Sister Temi Tayo.